Hello, and welcome to the fourth video in our TypeScript narrowing series. We're continuing from where we left off, so if you've missed any of the previous videos, I suggest you go back and watch them. In this video, we will cover tagged union types, also known as discriminated unions, and we have more to come in future videos. I'm Lucas Paganini, and in this channel, we release web development tutorials. Subscribe to the channel if you're interested in that. So, tagged union types. What are they? It's actually pretty self-explanatory. They are union types with a tag. For example, you could have a union type called log that aggregates three interfaces: warning, debug, and information. Cool, now we have a union type. To turn that into a tagged union type, we need a common property with literal types between our interfaces. It could be any property name, but to simulate a real-world example, we will call it subscribe to the channel. This property will serve as an ID for the different types of interfaces that make up the log type. Every interface will have a different literal type for that property. And that's it. The subscribe to the channel property is serving as a tag for the log type, so it is now a tagged union type. As I've mentioned before, this is also known as a discriminated union, and our subscribe to the channel property is the discriminant property of log. To quote from the TypeScript docs, when every type in a union contains a common property with literal types, TypeScript considers that to be a discriminated union. So, from now on, I will use the discriminated unions terminology instead of tagged union types, because that's how TypeScript is calling it nowadays, and I want to be consistent with the official terminologies. Even though I believe that tagged union types would be a better name for it. Okay, Lucas, I got it, but what's the point? What do I get with a discriminated union? Good question. What you get with a discriminated union is a type guard for all the possible discriminations of the union type. For example, if you have a variable called value, that is a log, that means that value could be either a warning, a debug, or an information. But instead of creating individual guards for those three interfaces, you could check the value of the discriminant property. If subscribe to the channel is like, you know that it's a warning. If it's comment, it's a debug, and if it's share, it's an information. And you can make your code even clearer by going an extra mile and switching your if statements. Got it? Switching? Switch? No. Okay. References and links for the previous videos are in the description. If you enjoy the content, you know what to do. And if your company is looking for remote web developers, consider contacting me and my team. You can do so on lucaspaganini.com. Have a great day, and I'll see you soon.